This one more time. Hey everybody, welcome back. This is Adolf Gaming, and today we've got a very fun video. We are going to be working towards forging the ultimate keyblade and Donald and Goofy's ultimate weapons. Now to do this, to unlock these options, we need to go through and try to craft everything possible in here. Then it will unlock what we're trying to accomplish. And we'll end up walking away with a bunch of good accessories at the same time, so it's not a half-bad deal. I've actually tried to do this a couple times so far, and it failed because even though I had enough materials, there were a couple key materials missing that I had to go back and grind for, so that kind of sucked, but this should be enough. Now this Moogle is going to give us Encounter Plus, which increases the chances of us finding Rare Heartless, which would have been nice during the initial grind, but honestly, I didn't have a hard time with it. I'm actually short on Dark Matter, so I'm probably going to have to come back and make several of these. They're only found in treasure chests throughout the game, and you can craft them here. See, these are the three majestic items we got going here, but we need two more Dark Matters, and hopefully I've got enough materials to make them without screwing me over here. Cool, let's see that. Synthesis Master for doing everything, and just to look at that ability we just got, it takes one, which really isn't that bad. I would honestly put it on if I had an extra AP, even though we totally don't need it now. This Keyblade, the ultimate Keyblade, has got a fantastic reach. I think it's the longest out of everything. Has a high strength, plus 2 MP, and possesses maximum power and attributes. How sexy. Then the Wizard Staff, I believe, gets replaced with Fantasia. Now, it greatly reduces his strength, but increases your max MP by 3. And the Wizard's Relic was giving us 2, but I would rather have Donald having as much MP as possible because I'm not really relying on him for that. 7 elements, I honestly don't know if I want to bother, but a shield that focuses solely on magic, raises max MP by 3, makes him way weaker, but more MP is really good. These weapons are fantastic, and there's actually a few other weapons in the game. Donald and Goofy's ultimate are, what is it called? I believe it's Save the King and Save the Queen, and we have to do special things to do those, including including not only beat the Hades Cup, but beat it in time trial and solo mode. So, thank God we have that done. I will work on equipping the accessories here in a second once we get to Merlin. I want to talk to him really quick because while I was grinding out in previous videos, I ended up running into enough of the white mushrooms to obtain each of the arts, and I believe there's a reward for getting each of the arts, which was a total pain in the ass. So let's talk to him. Dream Shield, that might have been it. And I will talk to Fairy Godmother just in case she's got anything else to tell me. I believe this is actually a better shield for Goofy, so I might end up actually switching this out here in a second. Nope, she's got Jack to say. So, we'll go back to Goofy. Mighty Dream Shield, there it is. This is the original shield that you see in-game when we were picking up our original stats. It's okay, it's not amazing. Honestly, the Defender is a hell of a lot better. Trying to see what all those numbers are. Mighty Shield. Offense. Maybe it's the attack power, not just the strength. So in this case, we're using 7 elements with 4. I think we're actually going to go back to Defender and just keep using that for a little while until I see something way better. Now, Sora, we've been having him use all these things. Let's see what all is down here because we've gotten lots of equipment. Now, I don't want to lose stats, so that would be kind of shitty for me to do. Fire resistance. You gotta give me a second, because there's a lot to go over. Raises max HP, MP, AP, strength, defense, also enhances summon. Oh my god, what an amazing item. So we're gonna put the Crystal Crown on, because that thing is awesome. I'm trying to look at my levels because the next thing on the list is to get everybody to level 100, and if we can accomplish that, then I can throw away all the accessories that have EXP boost for ones that actually raise stats like that just did. And that was pretty. So, just to double check what else we have. defense and hit points. Oh, Cosmic Arts would be pretty good too. I might actually say screw it and do it the long way, but... God, there's a lot of good equipment. We might just be grinding out the tournament a little just because it's funner. And yes, that is a word because I made it a word. Okay, so tons of hit points, tons of MP, tons of strength bonuses. Omega Arts there, AP and defense there. If I de-equip any of this stuff that does AP bonus, I'm going to have to take off equipment. So we're actually not going to worry about Donald Goofy right this second. Look at how much Sora's health and magic increased. That is disgustingly powerful. So... I think that's just gonna stay on, and I'm just gonna grind out more. Maybe. I don't know. I just don't know. Let's see what ability Sora can equip now that he's got an extra 5 of this. 1, 2. Arcanus Arts would be kind of nice. Guard Berserk. God, there's a lot of cool stuff. Aris Arcanum actually interferes with Ragnarok a lot, so I'm probably not gonna be using that one. We'll do Strike Raid. Treasure Magnet, Encounter Plus, Berserk, and Guard. We'll go ahead and do Guard. So that was really nice. Like, really nice. So I think we're good to go there. The next thing that I would like to do... I'm having second thoughts. Hold on. Let me undo what I just did because I don't want to do this. So Guard is what I chose. And... what did I say? Strike Raid? Was it Strike Raid? Okay. So, equipping Sora with... increases AP, increases experience obtained, but reduces that. We're gonna do EXP Necklace. EXP Ring. We'll leave the Crystal Crown on, I think, even though it would be super awesome to still be using that, but... that is a pretty big, intense bonus. Now that we've gotten that done, the next thing on my goal list is beating the Hades Cup. And just straight up beating it. Then probably off the road, I will come back and work towards the solo challenge and the time trial one. Just because that's kind of a kill time thing. So over here, we've got the list of everybody on here. Rock Titan, Final Battalion, like Rock Titan, Hades, then Cloud and Leon for round 20, Cerberus in round 30, Behemoth in round 40, and we're at 50. Now, basically there's a boss fight every 10 runs of this, but there's a huge amount of value to be able to complete this stuff, plus we unlock hidden bosses, and I really want to make a video of all the hidden bosses. We're level 72, the goal is to hit 100, so I don't mind doing all these tournaments over and over again. So, this is a hidden boss, we're not going to do any of the hidden bosses until the Hades Cup is totally done. And we can restart at any place we were at last time. So sometimes it's better to do the last 10 rounds and have the boss fight done over and over and over and over again, and get a big benefit that way. Instead of starting from the entire beginning. Just look at this sexy keyboard. I love this thing. This was so worth all the effort I put into it. So for the first round, it was just some soldiers and some shadows. Really weak stuff. Nothing too much to worry about. Next up, we've got White Knights and... Power Wilds, I think I said. Not really difficult. It's just more about chasing everything around the battlefield to get them killed off really quick. Still decent experience points. So Donald's already used half his MP bar because we probably should have reset his statistics, but that was my own fault. No big deal though. Again, we're not able to use summons on the tournament style, so we won't be able to enjoy any better than that. But I almost want to be level 100 when I take on all the bosses, but god, that thing is beautiful. But there's a lot of EXP you get from the hidden bosses, so it would be actually more worth my time to...
Come on!
80, some around 90, and then if I need to finish up, I can. Here we have some pot spiders and nothing else that's really worth my time. Next up, rare truffle. I forget about these guys. I believe they're useful for something.
Don't take that!
But I can't remember. The goal is to bounce them in the air as many times as possible without letting them hit the ground. The best way to do this is stage an environment where you can put them in the middle or in the corner. Now, here we've got Yuffie, but last time it was Yuffie and disable her. She's gonna be dead here in a quick second. I'm pretty sure she has no special gimmick power that I think can start. She would probably whip it out if I gave it enough time to happen. But basically, she goes from having tiny throwing stars, there's another shield, to having ultra awesome shields, or ultra gigantic shuriken, and it's just a pain in the ass. Or like, there's a team aspect we have to face. But for these guys, there's no. And everybody got a quick level. Except Spider. Usually these guys rotate pretty constant around one another. I'm half tempted to put EXP boosters on the rest of them to see if it would boost the party EXP, or if everybody is treated individually with their swords for strength bonus. I'm still waiting for a few hidden abilities to unlock, but honestly they might come around level 100, so there's no big deal. The biggest ability in the game is probably the most irritatingly useless ability, because it's called Trinity or Trinity Limit, and basically what it does is while Goofy, Sora, and Donald are on the field together, they end up doing like a mega attack that hits everything for a large amount of damage, but it costs the team their entirety of their MP, and it requires them to have so much to throw in the pot to begin with. So you basically throw out your entire workforce of power for one mega shot, and this is nice when you're in like large groups of enemies, like in these battle arenas, but it's kind of annoying. Oh hey, are we already onto servers? No, Behemoth, round 40, so we're 10 rounds in. Now this is a cool skin for the Behemoth, I'm really a huge fan of this. I don't have any
boots. Force! See ya!
I'm actually gonna spam now.
See ya!
Plus, getting on his back inside the Colosseum is actually really easy. You can just stand up on the stairs here. Search Ghosts and Red Nocturnes? I forget. That might just be the green ones. So, for magic, Blue Rhapsody. Okay, so they do change depending.
Nothing to it.
That is such a nice looking keyblade. I'm so happy I got that out. I believe there's an ultimate keyblade version in every sequel to the game too.
Come on!
So in the old days, the in-between rounds lasted a lot longer once all the enemies were actually dead. We're gonna take out the greens first. Really quick, and thank you. Knock out that guy before he turns to stone, and it's a total pain in the ass if he does, because then we have to literally wait 10 seconds for him to unstone so that we can deal with him. Pod spiders, fire, electric, not too bad. The only thing that's really tricky about these guys is knowing not to use their own element, because that would just heal them, and they'd be immune to it. So when you're just starting out in the game, it's kind of easy because you have a limited number of spells on your shortcut, but once you start getting extra spells and throwing out the elemental attacks, you have to just rely on physical combat or searching through the menu to find the correct one to attack with. Now, Marine Requiems are always the primary target because they can heal damage. And I want to deal with this piece. When you do enough damage, we get the beast version, not the boss version. For some reason, he's got like a jinx tier where he doesn't actually die, but he says he's gonna die. They're actually really annoying because of that. Taken care of. I forgot how many spells and equipments we actually got So you notice the arena changes. I don't think it actually grows in shape or size, but it does become more ominous. So now we have a flying group of enemies, not anything to worry about. So the only thing that really sucks.
Heal!
The only thing that really sucks is we don't get any drops or currency or anything. Otherwise, I would love to farm the tournament for all of the items, because then at least there would be a double benefit. This one is tricky because it's an unknown number of shadows, meaning that every time we kill one, they multiply. Not hard, but it does actually cost me right in. Surprisingly, we don't really fight any Neo Shadows, I don't think. I think those are primarily only in the end area where I did a bunch of grinding at the very last second. Just kind of a one of everything. So now we get some opposite armor over some dark balls. Typically with the opposite armor, the regular armor, because you're automatically going to hit the limbs while you're trying to hit the torso. Attack has to be primarily aimed at the head at that point. I didn't know that. I must have updated that. Battleships, I find personally very annoying because they have a habit of darting across the screen, getting too high out of reach for me to do anything about. That was easy.
That's the power of the Keyblade!
Cloud and Leon, round 20. This is gonna be cool. I'm actually gonna aim for Leon first. I'm not really worried about it. Either one of them. He might be looking to switch targets when he's got this enhanced laser.
Come on! This is it!
So that's a nice big chunk of EXP. It was like 3,000 in just one fight. We get the Lionheart for defeating Leon in this combo mashup. And now the arena actually changes shape to being more... In my opinion, I believe it's a little bit bigger.
Invincible.
Nothing to it.
To jump high into the air and then fall as the rain freezes up.
Yo, oh. Hey, how you doing, everybody? Yeah, got a minute? Hades, Lord of the Dead, nice to see you. Hey, guess what? I got a place for you.
So, nasty boss fight. Not even the big, big boss fight. Dealing with him is actually pretty easy. You want to keep your HP and your arrow up. You just kind of want to go at him first. He's virtually invincible. But once you knock off his invincibility, he becomes a lot weaker now. The super glide ability makes this a lot easier because you're basically able to fly around without too much of an issue. There it is. I don't believe it comes back on, but basically for us, this is just going to be about spamming. I hit him back with fire. I'm hoping down the road we can use fire.
Because
I'd rather he use his MVP.
Feel the heat.
The key is to stay close to Hades when he's doing his spin around. That can be a little bit hard to trace if you're not like practicing. I'm a little out of shape, but it could be hard. And we almost got him, so it's this guy's arrow, Erica, is able to counter very nicely. Bam!
Stop! Hey guys, get away from me!
Oh, so, he just got destroyed by darkness, and now we get the gravity upgrade and handsome report 8. We're going to try and finish off the entirety of Jimmy's book because there are several trophies related to it, and we need them all to get the platinum.
Come on!
Sometimes I have a habit of jumping out of the invincible attack just to land right back into it. Damn it, he got him out before I had a chance. I prefer that the attack is much sure. Damn, I jumped at the wrong time.
Goofy! Oh yeah!
I don't think these guys have gotten knocked out this entire time, unless I haven't been paying enough attention. The wreck reel. And that's a nice empty set. Damn it. I love it when the teleport fails and they just go to the exact same spot. That is like the best thing ever. I did that one-handed. Hey, Vermin Nikon. I'm distracted now. Okay, so in this case, we've got some invincibles. Let me not be able to do this. Again, he's gonna be difficult. Come on. HP bar is pretty
intense.
Get him.
Come on.
Got it.
Nothing to it.
Okay, so with white mushrooms, we're gonna make this really quick and painless, and we're not going to attack. We're just going to base attack them because, frankly, it would be pointless. We can't get any arts. We already did the arts. They're useless. Hmm. If they were Neo Shadows, it would be worried. Because even in theater, the Neo Shadows are like insane.
Goofy!
Now we have two Souths really easy, but again, their faulty hit point bar will make it easier.
Come on!
I'm just gonna focus on them all the time. The best way to avoid that is just to stay straight set with him and try to stay up in the air as much as possible. Not bad at all, and we make really good damage.
champs!
There we go. Same champion. Trinity limit, there it is. It wasn't learned up by levels, it was learned by actually doing. I don't know that. So anyway, we got a couple of skills, there's a couple spell upgrades, including Blizzard spell, and what was that, Gravity?
Force!
Gravity gets even cooler. Cure looks to be the only one that's missing out right now.
See ya!
Which is a bummer. So what I think I'll do is I'll cut this episode and then we will take on some boss fights. And I think I'll either do a compilation video of all of them back to back or basically just the ones in the arena. Alright, so we'll go ahead and stop this recording and I'll see you in the next video.